Now, we must stand in solidarity with disabled people. What the Tories are doing to them is absolutely disgusting. I'm a nurse, and I see patients who, because of the way that the funding is now, they can't even afford incontinence pads. This government are a disgrace for the way that they treat disabled people. We must support DPAC, and it gives me a great pleasure to introduce Bob Williams-Findlay. Make some noise!
Sister, comrades, welcome to the birthplace of DPAC. Yeah. 6 years ago, last time, the smell of greed and hypocrisy came to our city. A group of disabled people met not far from where Maggie May and her maggots are today. We said we will defend disabled people and other oppression from Cameron and of full age of austerity. Since then, DPAC have grown in strength and in numbers. We have taken the fight to the very heart of government. In our country and internationally. I want you to think about what it's like to have a mobility car. It gives you freedom to work, shop, have a life. And then one day get a letter saying you are going to be reassessed. You pick the new God and cures us. And suddenly the whole world is turned upside because PIP is designed to fail us. It is designed to reduce the number of disabled people on benefits designed to make us fit into their way of working. It was the Nazis who said work makes you a better people. This government is no better than them. They haven't killed thousands yet, but they have killed. Let's not forget it. So once you do your PIP assessment and you fail, you are trapped in your house. You might lose your job. You might not be able to take your family out. You may not be able to have a simple life. Comrades, in my opinion, up and down the country, there are political prisoners, disabled people, trapped in their homes like political prisoners. We have to unite to set them free. Yeah. Thank you.